Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our biology session. So in the last period of our biology, we have discussed about or we have started our new lesson, and the name of the lesson is what? Cell structure and functions. In this same lesson, we have discussed some point, we have discussed about the discovery of the cell. Also, we have discussed about the cell. In that, we have discussed the definition of the cell. Okay, so as we know that Robert Hooke discovered the cell, and what is meant by the cell? The basic unit of living organism, it is called as what? Cell. Okay, so in this today's lesson or in this today's lecture, we are going to see the next point from the same lesson. We are going to discuss about organisms show variety in cell number, shape and size. Okay, so what we are going to discuss in this set concept? Actually, as we know that there are the diversity of the plants and the animals present on the earth. There are the number of the plants and animals are present on the earth, or the living organisms are present on the earth. And very important, what? That each and every living organism is different from each other. Okay. Why? Because they are having the different shape and the size. Okay. So the organisms are having the different shape, size, and also they are having the different number of the cells also. Okay. Because of that, their body is having different structure, we can say that. So let's discuss about the first point, that is organisms show variety in cell number. Okay. So just now I said that there are so many living organisms present on the earth. So in that, there are the certain organisms, their body, as we know that human being, we will take as an example. So human being, we can easily see with our naked eyes, okay? But very important thing regarding that human beings are having so many cells present in our body, or we can say that the human being's body is made up of millions or trillions or the billions of the cell. Okay, next one is that just now I said that the human body is made up of so many cells, but do you know one thing about the cell? We cannot observe the cell with our naked eyes. Okay, so to observe the cell, what we have to do? We have to use the microscope. To observe the cell, we have to use microscope. So the scientists, those who are doing the study regarding the cell, they are doing their study under the microscope. And next one thing is regarding the cell is very important, that is what? The cell is colorless. Cell doesn't have any color. So how to observe that cell under the microscope? That is the reason. To observe the cell under the microscope very easily, scientists giving the color to the cell. Okay, they giving the color to the cell. Cell which is called as what? Stains. Okay, which is called as what? Stains. Stains means what? We can say dyes. Okay, means they give the different colors to the cell, or they are using certain chemicals to make the cell colorful, and that different chemicals which gives the color to the cell, they are called as what? Stains. Okay, so like there are saffronin is there. Okay, then it is the one example of the stain. So this is about what? Cell. We have to use the microscope to observe the cell. We have to make the cell colorful to observe it very properly. Okay, and that process is called as what? Staining. Next one. So just now I said that what? The human being is made up of the number of the cells. There are the so many cells are present in the human being. Then we can say that there are the billions or the trillions of the cells are present in the human body, and that is the reason the organisms which show the number of the cell, or the organism's body is made up of the number of the cell, then that organisms are called as multicellular organism. Okay, then that organisms are called as multicellular organism. Now let's see what is it by multi. Multi means what? Many. Multi means many, and cellular means what? Cell. Okay, so here what we can say? The organism, their body, if the organism's body is made up of number of the cells, multi means what? Many, many, number of the cells, then that organisms are called as what? Multicellular organism. After that, we can say that, as we know, the human being is a multicellular, or the organisms are also multicellular. But as you know, the organism, those who are multicellular, first they are also developed from the single cell. So what is this single cell? Single cell means what? Fertilized egg. Okay, as we know that embryo is there, as we have seen in our some previous classes. In the seed also there is an embryo. The embryo started to grow and then it makes the new plant. In this way also, in the reproduction of the animals or in the reproduction of the human being also, there is what? Fertilized egg. Okay, we are going to see this, what is my fertilized, how that fertilization process takes place in this upcoming lesson. But now today you keep in the mind is that what? The human being or the organism, those who are multicellular, they are also developed from the single cell. And which is that single cell? That is fertilized egg. Okay, which is that single cell? That is fertilized egg. So once this fertilized egg started to get developed, then it started to get multiply and it forms the number of the cell, which form the different body parts of human being or the different body parts of the living organisms. Okay, so here what you have to keep in the mind, the multicellular organisms are also made from the single cell. That single cell started to get multiplies. Okay, it started to form the cells and then it makes the different parts of the body. Okay, so this is about what? Multicellular organisms. Now we will move for the next one, that is what? So see here in the image you can see some organisms. Which are the organisms? Yes, correct. These organisms are like what? Paramecium and amoeba. Okay, so the amoeba and the paramecium are the unicellular organisms. Now what is meant by unicellular organisms? Uni means what? One. And cellular means what? Cell. Okay, so unicellular organisms means what? The organism, their body is made up of only one cell. Then that organisms are called as what? Unicellular organisms. Okay, so that amoeba, paramecium, these are the organisms which are made up of only one cell. But very important thing or very interesting thing about that, as we know that the multicellular organisms perform so many different functions like respiration, breathing, digestion, circulation is there. Okay, then also we can say that excretion is there, reproduction is there. In this way, all that process or all these functions are also performed by the unicellular organism. The unicellular organisms are also performing all these functions with the help of only one cell. Okay, with the help of this only one cell. Okay, so we just now we have said that what unicellular organism, for example amoeba. So amoeba is made up, the amoeba's body is made up of only one cell. But still amoeba can eat the food, they are doing the ingestion of the food, after that there is a digestion of the food, then after that they are also doing the respiration with the help of their body surface. The digestion of the food takes place, then the utilization of that food is also takes place, then the reproduction is also there. So all that process which are performed by the multicellular organism, all that functions are performed by the unicellular organisms also. But only the difference is that what? In the multicellular, to do that different function, different cells are there. Okay, different cells perform the different functions. And in the unicellular, what happens? Only single cell performs all the function. Okay, so this is about what? Cell number. Now we will move for the next one, that is what? Shape. Okay, what is the shape of the cell? See, just now we have seen in the image, that is what? Amoeba. So that amoeba doesn't have any proper shape. Okay, amoeba is having irregular shape. If you can see the amoeba like this, for this time, then in the next time you can see the different structure of the amoeba. Okay, why this is so? Because with the help of the single cell, the amoeba is doing the movement, and to perform that movement they are doing some projections of their body, and that projections of their body it is called as what? So projection of their body it is called as what? Pseudopodia. So like this they are making the projections, and then with the help of that they can move from one place to another place, or they can change their place. Okay, why they are doing like that? Why they are forming this pseudopodia? Why it is necessary to do the movement? Yes, it is very necessary to do the movement, because if they can feel the foods around them, then they are trying to capture that food. So that for that purpose they have to do the movement. Okay, so in this way what we can say that the amoeba is a single cell, or this single cell itself it is what? Organism. Okay, so this amoeba doesn't have proper shape, or the cell of the amoeba don't have any proper shape. Okay, so this is about what? Amoeba. As we know that in our body, or in the human body also, there are the some cells which does not have any proper shape. Which are that cells? That are what? WBCs. What is meant by WBCs? That are white blood cells. Okay, so this white blood cell doesn't have any proper shape. Why is it so? Because as we know that WBCs are called as what? Soldier of our body. Okay, why? Because they help us to fight against different diseases. They kills different germs which comes in our body. Okay, and might be for that is reason the WBCs also don't have any proper shape. Okay, so here we have seen the two examples. That is what? Amoeba. Amoeba doesn't have the proper shape, and the WBCs also doesn't have the proper shape. Okay, but my dear students, here we have to keep in the mind very important thing is that what? Amoeba itself it is an organism. It is a unicellular organism. This single cell is what? One organism. But in the WBCs, what happen? These are the cells. Okay, these are the cells. Okay, so this is a very much important difference between the WBCs and the amoeba. Both doesn't have the proper shape, but very important thing that amoeba single cell means what? Of one organism, while the WBCs are only the group of the cell. Okay, it forms the groups of the cell. Here we can say that. So this is about the shape of the amoeba and the shape of the WBCs. But next one is that in our body there are the so many different cells are there. As we know that our body also performs the so many different types of the functions also, and that is the reason to perform the different functions we are having the different types of the cell, or in a better way we can say that according to the function of the cell there is the shape of the cell. Okay, according to the function, which type of the function the cell have to perform, on the basis of that the cell is getting their shape. Okay, so there are the different types of the cell. There are the some spherical shaped cell are there, or the elongated shapes cell are there. There are the some cells which are long and pointed at the end, which are called as what? Spindle shaped cell. Okay, some cells are very long and they are having the branch like structure. Okay, that cells are present in our nervous system, or we can say that cell as a nerve cell or neuron. That cells are called as what? Nerve cell or neuron. So that nerve cell and neuron is branch and they are very long. Okay, so that cells are called as what? Nerve cells or the neurons, and they are very long and the branch. And with the help of that long and the branch structure, they can transfer and receive the different messages from the brain. And with the help of that, it helps to control our body. Okay, so this is what about what? Shape of the cell. Okay, so all the cells are doesn't have the proper shape, but most of the cell is having the proper shape. Only we can say that the amoeba cell and the WBCs doesn't have the proper shape. But as you know that why that cells are having proper shape. Okay, so why the cell is having proper shape? Remaining all the cells which are present in our body, they are having the proper shape. Why is it so? What is the reason behind that? Because the cell is having the cell membrane. The cell is having cell membrane, and inside that there are the so many different cell organelles. Okay? okay, inside them there are the so many different cell organelles which gives the shape to the cell. Or we can say that the cell membrane gives the proper shape to the cell. Okay, so as we know there are the two types of the living thing, that is what, animal and plants. Okay, so animals and plants, they are the both the living organism. It means what, they are also made up of the cell. Okay, so they are also having the different types of the cell, and the shape of the plant cell and the animal cell is also different. Okay, but the remaining all the components of the cells are same. So here why I am telling like this, the whatever the components are present in the cell, they are also present in the plant cell, but only the one thing is that this is what, cell membrane. Okay, along with the cell membrane there is a one more covering for the plant cell. There is a one more covering for the plant cell which is called as what, cell wall. Okay, which is called as what, cell wall. Okay, so the plant cell and the animal cells are having the proper shape with the, because of the cell membrane, and in that cell membrane there are the so many cell organelles are enclosed. Okay, but the only difference is that the animal cell and the plant cell is what, the plant cell is having one more layer or one more membrane around the cell membrane, which is called as what, cell wall. Okay, so this is about the shape of the cell. And now next one we will discuss about the size of the cell. So here is very important point, because as we know that there are the so many organisms, some are very big, some are very small. If we will take the example of the elephant and the rat, the elephant is so much big, so they are made up of the so many different cells, while the rat is very small, they are having the less number of the cells as compared to the elephant. But size of an organism doesn't matter with the function of the cell. Okay, so the size of the neurons or the size of the nervous cell present in the elephant and the size of the nervous cell present in the rat is exactly same. Okay, because the size of an organism cannot change the size of cell. Okay, it doesn't mean that elephant's nervous cells are big because the elephant is very big. No, it is not like that. The nervous cell present in the elephant is same as the nervous cell present in the rat. Why is it so? Because the function is same. Okay, what is the function? To transfer, to receive the messages from the brain. Okay, in this way here you have to keep in the mind, the size of an organism cannot change the size of a cell. Okay, so now we have discussed about there is no any relation of the size of an organism and the size of the cell. But in that cell condition also, I want to tell you one thing, is that the living organism's body is made up of number of the cells. There are so many different cells are present in the body. The living organisms are found in the millimeter also, and found in the centimeters also. Okay, some are very big, some are very small. Okay, so in this way, in our body there are the number of the cells, and their shape, size and structure is different. Okay, shape and the size is different. So if we talk about the number of the cells, as we know if they are very small, or the cells are very very tiny, they are very small, and that is the reason we cannot see the cell with our naked eyes. If you want to observe the cell, then obviously what we have to use, we have to use the microscope. We have to stain the cell, then only we can observe the cell. And why we have to use the microscope? Because with the help of the microscope we can magnify it. Okay, with the high magnification power we can observe the cell very easily. So which is the smallest cell? Okay, the smallest cell ranges from the 0.1 to 0.5, which is found in the bacteria. That is what, in cell in a bacteria, that is the smallest cell. And what is their size? 0.1 to 0.5 millimeter in bacteria. And why? Next one is that what is the largest cell, or which is the largest cell? The largest cell size forms in 170 millimeter into 130 millimeter, that is ostrich egg. Okay, because as we know that the egg, that we can say that is nothing but what, single cell. Okay, and which is the largest egg, that is what, ostrich egg. So that is the reason it is what, largest cell. And what is its range? What is its size? That is around 170 millimeter to 130 millimeter. Okay. So, my dear student, this is all about today. Today we will stop here. But before going to stop our lecture, we'll just revise what we have discussed. Today we have discussed about the number of the cell or the cell number. Also, we have discussed about the shape of the cell and the size of the cell. Okay. So, this is all about today. Today your homework is that whatever you can see on the board that you have to just mention in your notebook. Try to recall what I have discussed in the video. Okay. So, it is the time to tell you goodbye. We will meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.